Hello everyone, I'm Asher Postman, and in this video I'm going to show you how to record a guitar that sounds kind of like this. I'm just kidding. It's going to sound like this remix I made.
Yeah.
Alright, well first of all, this is a guitar. I'm just messing with you guys, we're not going to start that basic. That would be stupid. Also, this is not a guitar, it's a piano. You have a lot to learn today. No, but for real, I got a bunch of questions from you guys on my Instagram about things you want to learn about my guitar playing stuff. And I've gotten a lot of other comments on YouTube, so we're going to dive into what I do to record guitar and my songs, and specifically how I did it for this remix that you just heard. Alright, so for the next minute or so, I'm going to cover the basics of the guitar and how to record it. So if you already know that, then skip to this time right here. First of all, you're gonna need an audio interface. If you're a beginner and you don't know what that is, it's the device where you can hook up your monitors and record audio into your DAW. I remember when I first started, I didn't even know what that was, so you're welcome. Audio interface. You're also gonna want a guitar cable, obviously, and I would suggest buying one that's decently expensive and has the gold. I think that's important. It's a balanced cable, and that's going to eliminate noise, which can be a problem if you use a cheap cable. And yeah, you're just gonna wanna plug it in. 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 Oh, I actually got that time. And then obviously plug it into your guitar. Okay, now we go to our audio settings. Make sure that the interface is selected for input and output. Go to an empty channel, select input one left, because that's where we're plugged into, and it should be good to record. So you're gonna wanna arm this little record thing so that it's gonna record if you press R, and now the top left corner says it'll record. And now, if we play it, I did my best. For those of you who skipped ahead to this part, welcome back. You really didn't miss much. All right, so here's the project right here. Let's play the drop with that guitar part. Yeah, I'm gonna show you how this guitar part works. So one basic thing that you should know is that there are obviously some settings on this guitar. We got the volume knob and then like a high frequency knob and a bass knob. And then this little switch right here is what switches between these pickups, and they have completely different sounds. And so the settings that you use on the guitar are going to affect the tone quite a bit. So you wanna just mess around with that a bit. So this is on like the more rhythm setting, which is a little bit lower frequency. And if I just flip it all the way, it's more like country sounding and brighter, and then in the middle is like in between those two. And another thing is all guitars sound different, so the different guitar that you have is going to affect the way that the tone sounds quite a bit. So you just want to experiment and find the cool tone that you're looking for. So first of all, I have a guitar going through Guitar Rig, and Guitar Rig is the plugin that I basically use for pretty much all of my guitar tones across the board. If you don't have Guitar Rig, I would very highly suggest that you buy it if you want to be using guitars a lot, because it's basically a plugin that just has every kind of guitar effect you could want in one plugin, and it has amp stimulators and all that kind of stuff to make it sound like a real guitar recording. I found that it's kind of hard to find great presets, but I found some pretty good ones and then morphed them into what I like. So let me just show you what this preset is. It's really only two elements. So I have this amp simulator, which is this high white one, and it comes with like the amp part, which kind of distorts it and makes it louder. And then it pushes it into this matched cabinet, and that's what gives it like the guitar amp sound. But for this sound, I thought it was cool to turn it off. It has like a super bright tone. Yeah, so it just has that, and it has a compressor on it, and that's all I did for this Guitar Rig thing. I'm gonna cover a little bit more later in this video on other sounds in Guitar Rig, but that's all this sound is. So as you can see, this guitar part is all spliced up, and that's because I suck at playing guitar, and I couldn't play it myself. But there's a trick for that as a producer. What I did was write the part, and then I played little parts of that part in little sections, and then kind of just like pasted them all together. So it sounded like this at first. So I have all these options, and then what I do is I go to the settings and I go to generic bleeding so that it fades and there's gonna be no clicking and popping when I splice stuff together. And then I just like put all the audio parts together to create the one lick that I wanted. Also a cool trick is if you hold down shift and then scroll with this mouse scroll thing, you can like correct the time really easily so that you can line it up exactly how you want it. And so yeah, that sounds pretty cool by itself, but one thing that I like to do is add some more effects on top of the guitar part to make it more unique and make it just more of a cool part. So this is what it ended up sounding with all the effects on. And I'll show you one by one what I did here. So first I have Serum Effects, which has this stereo widening function, the hyper dimension thing. And that just widens it out quite a bit. And I have a phaser on there as well, and a little bit of a compressor. And then some EQ, just taking out a little bit of low mids and adding some more bass so that I had a little bit of a cool like plucking sound like in the lower register. And here's where the real secret tricks are. I threw on Manipulator, which is a vocal plugin, but it has a cool stereo feature. And so I turned the stereo up a little bit and put the mix to 30%. And that just makes it like really super wide. And then to make it even wider than that, I put Fruity Flangus on here. And now it's just like super, super wide. Then just a little bit of small room reverb, and then of course, OTT. And now it's just sounding super bright and super wide and everything. And besides that, I just used a little bit more EQing for mixing and taking out some of the mids and high mids. So yeah, and then I just threw a sidechain compression on there. And so now it just fits really well into the drop. And honestly, yeah, that's as simple as it is. It's really easy to create little guitar parts, splice them together if you're not good at playing guitar, and just add some effects. All right, so that's how I did the guitar plug for my remix. There are way more ways to process a guitar, so I'm gonna try to walk through a couple other ideas and show you a bit more about Guitar Rig and other ways to record your guitar. So here's another preset that's actually a lot similar to the other one. This is the one that I used for my song Say. You can probably recognize it. And yeah, so that's what it sounds like with this cab on it versus that other sound. Let me show you this one too. So this is more of like a crunchy one that you would use for like power chords, which a lot of you might recognize from my Chainsmokers remix. And yeah, that's just different settings here on Guitar Rig. I've got a compressor that's compressing quite a bit, which gives it a really cool sound. When you smash the guitar before or after the amp with a compressor, it makes it pop more and have more of a transient. So I love this tone because it has a little bit of crunchiness and a little bit of distortion. And then Control Room is kind of like a amp simulator, cabinet simulator. And yeah, that's also super simple. Like I said, Guitar Rig has a lot of crazy presets that you might never use. And so it's a bit hard to find stuff that you like. But once you get to know the basics of how it works, you can kind of create your own sounds. For instance, if I turn this up a lot, it becomes like a alternative guitar. Here's a tone that I kind of developed and I really like. It sounds a lot like that Zane song. And this is just a different amp, so it has a different tone to it. And then utilizing these different cabinet simulators and then adding a chorus, which is doing a lot of the work. And then I got a delay and a reverb on there as well. And so yeah, Guitar Rig is really cool because you can just create like a whole tone just within this plugin. I know there's a preset on here called like Clean Cave or something. And that's more of like an ambient guitar tone. And as you can see, that's just like adding a ton of reverb and everything. It's honestly just a simple sound, just this normal amp with no distortion on it, and then all these different cool techniques of adding delay and reverb and all that kind of stuff. One cool trick I like to use in FL Studio is actually if you go to this tab right here, you can click on it, it'll say either pre or post. And if it's on pre, then when you record, it'll record the audio before the effect. Let me just try it and show you real quick. So you can hear it has all the effects on it, but I can go back into this channel and mute Guitar Rig, and it's just the tone here. So now, when I turn this back on, I can go find any preset that I want, and now it will play it. So I can like switch through effects and change the way that my guitar sounds even after I record it. Yeah, it's very simple. If you guys don't have Guitar Rig, I would definitely suggest getting it or something like that. I know there's other plugins as well. If you don't have the budget for anything like that, you could honestly just record some guitar and throw effects on it that just come with FL Studio. Like I can throw some EQ on here. Maybe a Fruity Flangus. How about some reverb as well? And then some OTT. And yeah, that's kind of cool sounding, and I didn't even use Guitar Rig. No excuses. Yeah, so that's how I record my guitars and edit them. Honestly, you probably should not take any of my advice because I am not a guitar player at all, but I do my best, and maybe you learned something good in this video. Let me know in the comments if there's anything I missed that you want to learn about, and if you're not already subscribed, dude, subscribe, it's not that hard. And that's all I got for this video, so peace. Yeah. Switching up here.